Hey everybody, Tom Barnish, Chicago scene up in Vernon Hills at Evergreen. And you might be asking why up here, what's Evergreen? Well, how do you get to be the general counsel of the Alinea Group to making waffles? Well, Emily did, and I'm gonna tell her story now. I'm gonna go inside. This is her new production facility where she makes her waffles, and it launched just before the pandemic, and it is now taking off. So I'm gonna talk to her about the whole process and what makes her the Chicago scene. All right, so this is how you go from general counsel of Alinea to owning your own brand in itself. This is Emily, and you're in charge of Evergreen, right?
That's right.
So talk about, how does that happen from corporate counsel, general counsel, I should say, of Alinea, which is one of the leading restaurant groups in the world, to, you know, giving that up, hanging it up, retiring, if you will, to your own version of the waffle in this healthy way that you're doing it?
Very good question. I was driving home from work one day, and I was listening to a podcast about food that was talking about the frozen breakfast market and how big it is and how it's still dominated by that brand that rhymes with Lego. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I was expecting my first daughter at the time, knew I was going to need to feed her a frozen waffle as a working mom.
Absolutely.
Who had to run out the door in the morning. But knew I wasn't going to want to feed her that brand. And when I started looking around to see what better for you options were out there, realized that none of them were all that much better for you. They still had preservatives and refined sugars and artificial colors and flavors. And so I was inspired to make a better option.
And you did that by no, like, really huge formal training as far as a chef. You were just a you know, probably above average chef at home with your family, right? Just really into it. But it wasn't like something that you set out for. I mean, you came from the law side of the professional world to this, right? So it was just about the ingredients and what you're feeding your kids, right?
Yes. To be clear, I was a lawyer at Alinea, not in the kitchen. But I did, I've always loved cooking and baking, and particularly passionate about, you know, making things from scratch. I went through a period of my life before I had children where if I wanted almond milk, I would make my own almond milk.
Oh,
if
wow.
I wanted there a sandwich, I would make my own bread for that sandwich. So I liked playing around in the kitchen. I liked getting my hands dirty. I basically opened up my pantry, looked at the most nutritious ingredients that I had, whole grains, eggs, fruits, vegetables, nuts and spices, and threw that all into a waffle.
So how did you get to the point of where you are now using the recipe that you're using? Did it take like months of mistakes or months of just eating mistakes to figure out what you wanted, you know, more fruit or more vegetables with the batter? How did that all come about?
I like to say, bless my husband, who has had thousands of waffles over the last several years. Mm-hmm. But yeah, no, it took about a year of tinkering with recipes. I started off, for example, in our chocolate chip and matcha waffle, I used real chocolate chips. And then when it came time to generate a nutrition label to bring this to market, realized that chocolate chips have maybe 5 ingredients in them. And I really wanted all of our waffles to have the most streamlined list of ingredients possible. Simple ingredients. And so I swapped out chocolate chips just for cacao nibs.
And that is the process of how it all happened, right? Just a little, learning from your mistakes as you go to the point now where you have this facility behind you where everything kind of just happens right here with the staff that you have behind you, right?
That's right. Yeah, it was just me and my kitchen and my single mini waffle iron that I bought from Amazon Prime to what you're seeing behind me.
And that was, you started off like that in that spot, and then you did like a couple of the shared kitchen things and moved up to this spot here. And now, how many waffles are you cranking out a day to ship out, or how do you put that all together?
Yeah, no, we make thousands of waffles here a day to ship out to stores all around the Midwest. We're in the Northeast, and we actually have a pallet in our freezer right now that's about to go to Southern California for the first time, which is really exciting.
And you also do in your part to help out people who are in need. You're doing some for, was it a pantry that you had in there?
Yeah, I studied in law school, actually, food law and policy, and became really passionate about food insecurity and food deserts. And so whenever I can, I donate product to a food pantry in Chicago called Common Pantry. And so we have another pallet in our freezer right now that is waffle, we were testing a new recipe, and so we can't sell those waffles, but I can donate them. So we're really excited to be able to give back.
And from the waffle to the packaging, it all happens in this space here, right? All out of here?
It's all out of here. That's right.
And it's, it's not a gigantic staff just because you're still growing and you've only been doing this for how long? Right before the pandemic started, right?
Yeah, we hit shelves in Whole Foods in the Midwest the second week of March 2020. So,
kind of a silver lining where it might have been difficult to break into the market back then if it wasn't for the pandemic, but because people weren't going out, ordering things online, picking up at the store. For you, it was almost, this serendipitous moment in that aspect, not the pandemic, I'm saying, but just more about the timing for your business.
Yeah, no, it was a time when people were filling their freezers with whatever they could get their hands on.
Among toilet paper and everything else, everybody was stockpiling everything, right?
Right, yeah. But freezer items were certainly up there, so I'm sure that people grabbed Evergreen off the shelf, not knowing what it was, willing to give us a chance in those early days just because they wanted something in their freezers. So in that way, certainly, I think perversely, the pandemic has benefited us some. On the other hand, we haven't been able to market in the normal way we would, so you don't see sample tables in stores anymore, and that is such a good way for new brands especially to raise brand awareness. So we haven't had those opportunities. So,
but those are on the horizon?
I think they are on the horizon, hopefully.
So for people who want to know more about you and your brand and your story, what's the best way for people to get in touch with you and then also get your waffles?
Sure. So our website is www.eatevergreen.com. Our social media handles across all channels are at Eat Evergreen. In the Midwest, in Chicago, we are sold in Whole Foods, we're in Foxtrot Market, we're in select Mariano's, but also if you visit our website under Find Us, you can find our whole list of stores.
And do you ship to people, or is it, go ahead.
Yes, no, we do. We ship nationwide on dry ice, the waffles you see behind me, and you can get them anywhere in the United States.
Awesome. Well, Emily, best of luck to you in this new endeavor. It's got to be a little scary dropping something that you did for your whole professional life to switch gears, but I think that's the common theme for a lot of people in the pandemic that have found their passion. So good for you.
Thank you so much. Life is short. You gotta do what you're passionate about.
Absolutely. Well, I wish you nothing but the best.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. All right, there you have it, T, B-A-R-N-A-S at WGNTV.com. That's T Barnes at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, as always, thank you for watching. I appreciate it.